Welcome. Now we have a Capricorn full moon. Scale mountains to gain a sense of achievement. So we have elevated. And this is connected to the sun entering Leo, Leo season here on the 22nd. A time of celebration and success with joy. And we know that we just had our sun in Cancer and we were working on focusing on our home and our love. With our new moon in Cancer, belonging, a sensitive introspective phase. Now, remembering the moons are connected, so our new moon in Cancer connection to our full moon in Capricorn. So we're having an accomplishment with belonging. And what this is connected to is this message. It has to do with being naked. And working with the element of water. Right here. So we have water. This ancient mermaid goddess influences emotions and gifts her followers with clairvoyance and healing powers. And it has to do with hide no more. The emotional nakedness you avoid is your superpower, not your shame. And what this is connected to is Cancer season and the crustacean. And the end of Cancer season, the beginning of Leo, prepping for our 8-8 portal on August the 8th. And this crustacean, when it molts, it becomes very vulnerable in order to do so. And we know we had a crustacean crossing the road to get to the other side for one of our messages here during Cancer season. And we're going to be vulnerable enough to let the real us shine through. Vulnerability is a strength, not a weakness. And remember, we're all doing this together. We're all doing this as a collective. So we're going to practice being transparent, starting with the people closest to you. Say, I haven't been showing up as the whole me, but I'm starting today. Have the courage to feel and express your feelings without people pleasing. Oh, we're not necessarily, guys, I'm not going to go say that. But I'm going to embody it. And get the gist of the message of what it's saying. Just to speak we're going to speak our truth, share our stories, and cultivate appreciation for vulnerability in others. Become comfortable with being uncomfortable and making others uncomfortable. Goddess declaration. I have the courage to be vulnerable. And this is going to offer us much growth, because with the sun being here, thanks to Leo season, something's being activated here, and we're going to find out what it is, okay? And it is connected to the Nine of Cups. And this is where we transmute our sadness into happiness. We do the work. And that's connected to the Ace of Cups, the work that we're doing to expand our soul with spirit. Now here, she's still connected to these two cups. That's love. As well as these three cups plus three cups, we have the Six of Cups, pleasure. This is what's being activated with this full moon in Capricorn. Through some sort of tower moment, something was activated here in order to expand, to have that growth. And it has to do with this. It has to do with being naked and having the growth here. Everything we just shared in that message. So let's see what's officially being activated here with the Moon Oracle. What is being activated here? There you go. It's Ishtar, the white goddess of Pisces. And this is where we're being forced to transform with our strength and our connection to all of life. All of life, plants, animals, with the fountain. And here is the rest of our transformation. This is Aquarius energy. Okay. Now, this has to do with the fact that the next card out was the Hangman. So this is where we're being forced to be the positive charge, and it's connected to the Seven of Cups. There was a debauch within the Seven of Cups. This is a corruption of the senses, and it's connected to the Devil. Separation, where the Devil's using our heart's desires to keep us from elevating and keeping us in separation. But look, there's a third eye activation here. Now, let's see what it's connected to. What is happening here? What is it connected to? Okay. The truth, a transformative truth with the Princess of Swords. So the element of youth is here. The inner child is on board. And what is this truth connected to? Our swiftness. Look at that. Look at her go. This is understanding action. This is understanding how to use action. We get our thoughts, the element of air, in alignment with our actions. And look at this now. So here's our strength being activated. Thank you to this Leo season with the Three of Pentacles. So really, the strength is being activated with, as you can see, this connection to this full moon. This full moon in Capricorn to our new moon in Leo. And it's love. Remember, this has to do with love. Right, and right now we're having an interference with the element of air. So we need to get back to work with new patterning. And this is all new patterning. With our Three of Pentacles pals, many times we're working on these new patterns. But here we're not. We're working on these alone. We're working on these with God. Now let's see what this interference is connected to. Because this interference is part of the plan to activate our truth with our strength and our swiftness through action. Remember, it's not enough just to think it, we're becoming it, and to become it, it has to do with action. Let's see what Ishtar has to say here, because the white goddess of Pisces does, she was right here. She has something to say. There's the connection to March here. Okay, so we're going to whatever this has to do with, we know this has to do with water. So we're going to, as water is our connection to the feminine and also La Luna. Let's see what's being activated here. We are connecting to, of course, with Ishtar here, the white goddess of Pisces and the hangman. That is sensing with the water element, that is sensing through the negative, that is sensing with our emotions, and connecting to the 5D and beyond, and shifting it back into the 3D. And then we're gonna, there's growth, remember. We're gonna grow with the sun and celebrate. There's that connection to the Three of Cups here. Guys, I want you to see it landed right out onto. Isis, rebirth, and there is our connection to Leo and Lionsgate Portal 88 and our rebirth. And remember, our rebirth happens beyond time and space. So this has to do with our inexperience and being vulnerable, our inexperience in being naked here and being comfortable being naked. So now we're going to have the experience to be naked. But this is through action. This is the key. This is happening through action. Because that's Leo, the father, the fire, the sun. And Leo is going to have no problem being naked. And I do believe this is who we're expanding with here, guys. Hang tight. Let's just check out the rest of the information. I love to slow down and check it out. I mean, sometimes we have to slow down to speed up. Yeah, look at this, guys. This exact time we're in. From Cancer to Leo. A heroic female figure with red brown wavy hair emerges from an urn out of which gushes a cool sparkling fountain. She is bathed in the pale blue flowering waters. She wears a winged helmet, symbolizing the ability of the imagination to take flight and reach great heights. Her demeanor is tranquil and confident as she looks out of the card towards the viewer. Her head and shoulders are framed by a pale sun-like full moon. Well, we're on point. The divine is here. So, this card is connected to sharing our gifts. And when we're working with Neptune and the sun, our connection, look at that, to Pisces and expanding with the sun. So, Ishtar is here. This is why it's so important to slow down and get all the information sometimes, right? Oh. And the sun. Right? So, and we know Ishtar, Pisces, is our connection to expanding with Neptune. Pisces and Neptune are connected, allowing us to heal from manipulation, emotional manipulation of ourselves and others. And expand with the Father, our fire, our passions, and our individuality. And here, just look at here it is. And we heal from what's happening in concession here. And there's our connection to Capricorn and expanding from gossip, expanding from what's happening within, lower vibrational in the element of air. This is gossiping. This is sharing things we shouldn't share. This is like, even sharing our like personal things sometimes we should not be sharing between lovers, between people. Like, You know, when you should be working something out with your partner and you're working it out with your best friend. And that doesn't mean, hey, we don't get support from our loved ones, but there's a difference here. There's a difference here. We're not gossiping. We're not engaging in lower vibrational things. We're not being called to do that anymore. There's an elevation here. We're seeing a new way. We're seeing a new way to communicate. And this way of communication, it makes us feel deserving and deserving of love. And it clears up so much karma for us. And there it is. There's Guru. There's Pisces. There's where we expand with our lower chakras here. And an elevation is honored. And it's happening through this mansion with Neptune, denoting the expansion of the imagination, allowing the visionary the ability to achieve great heights. And that's, we know, we have to achieve great heights. Okay? It's right here. To achieve great heights, signifying recognition, right? Achievement of your own creativity by yourself and others, and indicates a sudden surging in the powers of your imagination. You must accept responsibility for your own talents and use them for the good of yourself and others, urging you to believe in your own many and varied abilities and their worth to other people. Okay, now let's see how it ties into this message here. Empowerment message. The process of soul retrieval, resurrection, and rebirth is the same recurrent through the stories of the Egyptian goddess Isis, the one that she invites you to address now. This is a powerful moment to see some of what you thought you'd lost go through a process of regeneration to live again. Like magic, the pieces of you that were considered lost in the old wounds and stories are already being reclaimed into a healthier, more mature version. Where you were hopeless, now there is hope. Where you were lost, where you lost your faith, you have the capacity for even more now. So look at that. We lost our faith, but we have the capacity for even more now. Where there was inequity and injustice, now you can see a better way. Where you were abandoned, now you can choose you. You are ready to face these parts of yourself and to gather them together as you step into a newer, more powerful version of yourself, your work, and your relationships. Your creativity. Have courage. Let go of blame. Claim your accountability and then co-create something better. You can do this. The goddess Isis has come to help you as a potent supporter in your growth. Alignment message. The goddess Isis, with her powers of reincarnation, has a message for you. You're not broken. You're not wounded beyond healing, and opportunities are not necessarily lost forever. Your insistence on defining yourself by your losses and wounds and your stories are not serving you. Your alignment task is to fully accept things as they are. Choose to find a way to put the pieces back together. Let die what doesn't serve you and focus on what works. There is so much goodness to come from the situation, even if in this moment you feel trapped. Wow. And I feel like many of us are feeling trapped. Like that's the message. We feel trapped. And we try to co-create something and we feel stuck in it. But the message is to cope. To co-create it anew. Not give up. But to let go of what's not working. The goddess Isis wants only the best for you. Ask your fierce ally. She will challenge you when you go off track. So pick up the pieces, tell a new story, and find home again. You will be amazed at how beautifully things come together when you reject the trap created by the stories you tell yourself. You have the key, use it. So look at that. This has to do with the connection to home. Find home again. Right? Well, that's what we're doing. We were focused on your home and love life. And this has to do with belonging and being vulnerable and feeling safe to share all pieces of ourselves. And look, we're not a victim. Yes, do things happen? Look, this isn't where things happen to us, they happen through us. We're not a victim, we're a co-creator. We can continue to tell our victim stories and stay in our victim templates, but then we're just a victim and we're stuck. We are powerful co-creators that can co-create anew and heal our victim templates. And that's what we came here to do. We have the key. So we're not telling these stories of poor us anymore. These are not poor us stories. You know, and this one sounded kind of harsh. Like, yeah, we've all been hurt. We've all been wounded. But that's the thing. We've all been hurt. We've all been wounded. And we can't, you know, you start comparing your life to other people, judging other people. That's a very dangerous game to play. We all suffer. We all bleed. We've all been backstabbed and betrayed and hurt. And we all have our own story. But this is elevating from that. We're not victims. We're co-creators. What did we learn? What did we learn from our suffering? Like, pain is one of our best motivators and teachers. What did we learn from our pain? What did we learn from our suffering? What did we learn when we turned our sadness into happiness with the Nine of Cups and wish fulfillment? What did we learn there? Because we learned something. Okay, where are we going? Well, there it is. That's dealing with our heartache right there. And the Ten of Pentacles. Look at that right there with this Capricorn full moon. So it has to do with action. The Nine of Wands is here. We put down eight wands. We have one wand. This is our connection to the feminine. This is where action works with the feminine. Okay, so it's being activated here. Strength, there it is again. It's strength in order to go within and transform. It's strength to be vulnerable and be like the crustacean and molt our shells. So how's it happening? Well, there it is. There's a transformation here. There's a metamorphosis connected to purity. There's a purification being honored here. This is a white rose. Our connection to a white flower, connection to purification, okay? And here you can see there's going to be a birth of a whole new self here, a transformation between the masculine and feminine. In order to help manifestation with action, with the father, with the fire, from what? Yeah, lack of. This is our victim template. Remember, we're going from the Five of Pentacles to the Ten of Pentacles, thanks to strength. But look, there is an illusion that we need to see through. What is it connected to? This is why we have to go within. This is why we need to have strength. What is it connected to? Feeling called to go somewhere else. Let's see what it's connected to. Oops, sorry, Biscuit Boo. Because something good is going to come of this. Something good is going to come of this. When we see through this illusion. And it's connected to a temptation. Remember, it's part of the plan. Okay. is going to come of this. Everything that we've all tied it up into a beautiful little bowl. Thank you to the divine. Love. Through the Three of Fire. Look, that's what we're manifesting. It's right there. There's the Three of Fire right there. So we're manifesting with the Three of Fire, our connection to Leo season, and the King of the Earth, our connection to this full moon in Capricorn. And it's love. That's what good is coming of this. Love. Look at what the Three of Fire offers us. The Three of Wands. Look, so we're on the path towards our abundance and opportunities. Trust ourselves so we can make good choices. Co-create. Look. To co-create situations and relationships that are in harmony with my heart's desire. And that's what this is about. This is about a harmony in love. So, love, oneness. In all of life, there is only the illusion. Look. What was this for? Illusion. Right? There is only the illusion of separation. In fact, we are all reflections of one another. When I make choices, I tend to see things as either or. What if every choice I make is about an experience, a sharing, and exploring? When I choose to see the unity in all things, magic abounds. Love is all around me. Spirit loves me unconditionally, and I can give and receive abundant love. Yes, we can. Much love. Until next time, you know I'm sending it to you. Those good, good healing vibes, guys. I can't wait to see you again when we expand. Take care.